In this video, I'm going to talk to you about radon mitigation and just help you to understand how these systems work. They're really not that complicated. Radon is an odorless, colorless, radioactive gas, and it is leached out from the soil, and when it hits living spaces in our houses, it can cause problems over the long term. So this is not something that's an emergency over, you know, a few days or a week or even months, but over long term, over years, it can cause lung cancer and other issues. So it is something to be concerned about. Very often when you're buying a house or selling a house, radon testing takes place as part of either federal or state regulations. And if that radon is detected, then a mitigation system is put in. And when it's put in after the fact, in other words, the construction is already done and now you have to do something about the radon, it's a very simple system, and it's basically a large vacuum cleaner that in effect you're putting in. And I'm going to explain to you how these systems work. I'm going to go from the top to the bottom. So we're going to start up on a roof and then work our way down to the basement where the radon comes in. And I'm just going to explain to you how it works and how you can maintain these systems. All right, well, I said I was going to start from the top to the bottom, and I am. So I'm kind of doing this backwards. So we're here outside in this house, and what I wanted to show you was this penetration on the roof of a 4-inch PVC pipe. It's got a little cap on it. And this is where the radon abatement, in this particular instance, is putting the gas. It's sending it through the roof in a 4-inch pipe and exhausting it to the outside. Now, sometimes you'll see these 4-inch pipes, you know, along the outside walls of the house. So there's different ways of getting it to the outside. In this case, it went through the roof. But in all cases, the whole point is to get this radon gas out of the house and vent it to the outside. So you're going to see a 4-inch pipe, it's almost always a 4-inch pipe, going to the outside somewhere along the house. And so we're starting at the top here. Now I'm going to move inside and show you the heart of this whole system. All right, I'm on a rickety ladder in this garage here. And I want to show you the heart of a radon abatement system. And that's the fan itself. This 4-inch pipe goes through the roof, as we saw before. And it comes down, and this fan here is on at all times. And basically what we're doing here is creating basically a low-powered vacuum cleaner with 4-inch PVC pipe, and this creates the vacuum here. This fan just continually runs. It doesn't have a huge amount of suction, but it's enough to cause a negative pressure downstairs, where I'm going to show you, down in the basement. And so this fan has to be on. You can actually hear it running here. And sometimes there's additional electronics with it that just make sure it is on, and maybe sounds an alarm if it goes off or something like that. Sometimes it's just the fan itself. But, and there's different powers or speeds you can get with these fans. So if you're replacing one, all you have to really do is look at the specs, and you can find one probably online to replace if you need to. But there's nothing particularly special about it. It's just a fan. It's connected to the PVC, in this case with these connectors here, but sometimes there's other methods. Sometimes this is located on the outside of the house. As I said, this one's located inside in this garage here. And actually, you can notice on this 4-inch pipe, there's a bunch of like moldy or mildewy residue there because this fan is always on and it's drawing air from the basement. And the temperature differential in the garage versus the basement air coming up can sometimes cause condensation, which is why we get this mildew here. And that's something to think about. But whether this is located inside or outside, it's all doing the same thing. It's just a fan running, creating kind of a giant vacuum cleaner. And now we're going to go down to the basement and show you where this ties in and how it works. Okay, we followed this 4-inch PVC pipe from the roof through the garage where the fan is located. And now it's coming into the basement through this wall. The opposite side of this wall is the garage. So the 4-inch pipe comes in, and it's dropping down, and eventually gets down to the concrete slab. And this is where our collection is going to take place. Now you can see here, we're sharing the connection into the slab with a sump pump. So this pipe over here is just a regular sump pump, nothing special. And this pipe here is the radon collection. And we're sharing the top of this lid to this sump pump pit. Now there might be different arrangements, but this is a very common thing where you see the radon collection sharing the lid of the sump pump. Now you could also see this pipe just going straight into the slab, which is also fine, but in some means you have to get this 4-inch pipe into the underside of the slab. And the reason for this is that radon gas leaches out through the soil, and when it hits the bottom of the slab, it's going to find cracks or holes in the slab and get into living space where we're going to breathe it in. We don't want that. So by creating this negative pressure underneath the slab, we can suck up that gas before it gets into the living area. So as a result of that, you can see it's very critical to seal up any cracks or holes or anything in the slab. So in this case, you know, this has been caulked. Underneath this tape is caulked, so air can't escape from the crack between here and the pipe. There's a foam sealant here. The cement goes up to the lid here. So however your sump pump is set up, if that's how it's tied in, all those cracks need to be sealed. And if the pipe goes straight into the slab, then that also needs to be sealed. And of course, you have to look around in other places too. So any cracks between the wall and the slab, for example, would have to be sealed with caulk or some other method. And if there's a crawl space somewhere, that needs to be sealed with either a special type of plastic, which is sealed to the walls so the gas can't escape. Anywhere where there's a chance for where the soil leaches the gas to meet the living area, that needs to be sealed. And by doing that, we're creating this negative pressure, as I say, and this vacuum cleaner system, if you want to think of it that way, sucks the radon gas, sends it outside away from us, and we're safe. So that's basically how these systems work. As you're maintaining these systems, as I said, the fan outside can be replaced. You can buy those on the internet. So if you're paying attention and the fan stops running, or if you have a light that monitors the fan and the light goes out, then you want to check into that and make sure the fan is still running and just replace them. They're not even really that expensive, probably $100, $150. And maintaining these systems, you got to make sure if it ties into a sump pump or ties into a hole in the slab, that those cracks and holes are sealed. You know, look around your basement, make sure any cracks are sealed with caulk or another method so that, you know, air can't escape. And that's really all there is to it. It's not rocket science, as I say, but by creating this negative pressure, we keep the gas out of the living area, and that's what's important. There are testing kits you can do yourself if you want to test to make sure the radon is escaping as it's supposed to. And if it's not, you may need to call an expert in, but it may be just a matter of sealing up cracks, potentially adding another fan if necessary, and you can keep this gas out from the living area. As long as you do that, you're going to stay safe.